What up, Shredder? There is a certain kind of day in snowboarding where one person has the best day of their life. They're whooping like an idiot and they're high out of their mind. And another person is mentally and physically exhausted, crying and screaming at their partner. That kind of day is the pow day, and the person screaming is my girlfriend. It's Christian from Shred School, and today we're going to talk about how to ride pow like a pro. So your next pow day is one of the best days of your life. But first, if you never want to miss a video, go ahead and subscribe to the channel, hit notifications right now. While you're at it, smash that like button. Look, I know not everyone loves pow, but when you ride the chairlift up on a pow day and see hundreds of people whooping like toddlers and making the noise they never, ever make in any other area of their life, you have to admit that there must be something to the feeling to make full-grown adults act like this. Now, if you're already a powder hound but don't ride very often, I have one word of advice for you. Move away from the East Coast or the Midwest to somewhere you can actually get some pow. And if you've never had a pow day, well, you're gonna sink like a rock and have to climb out of the powder like 20 times. And you'll probably cry, but don't feel bad, you'll get better next time. Some people describe riding pow as learning to snowboard all over again, but with this video, you can learn in a fraction of the time. I grew up in the East Coast, so I didn't really get to ride pow until I had been snowboarding for about 8 years. In fact, I'm still learning some of the finer details about riding pow. Like board selection. If you set your stance back on your board before riding pow, it is 100 times easier and your back leg will burn less. I just started doing this last year, and I've been riding close to 25 years, so you can see it takes time to learn this stuff. You can also ride a directional pow board that's made to float. Although I found that my high-performance park board, the Rome Mod, still crushes it in pow, but sometimes people give me funny looks in the lift line. You can ride pow with any kind of board. Just set your stance back, and if you're serious about pow, consider getting a separate board for those days when it absolutely dumps. Next is your outerwear. Ditch the sweatshirts and wear actual outerwear to the mountain to keep you dry. The problem with pow is you get sweaty coming down the mountain, and then the sweat freezes on the lift. Not to mention, on a pow day, it's usually cold out because it's windy and snowy. Wear a proper base layer and a waterproof outerwear. Keep your jacket zipped up at all times, double check your pocket zippers, and set up your powder skirt on your jacket and your pants to keep the snow out. Even better, get bibs for snow pants and stop getting a snowy lower back. Now, on a pow day, you want to be the first person in line when the lift starts turning, even if it means waking up at 4 a.m. Trust me, it will be worth it. The first run of the day on a pow day might be 100 times better than the second run, if it's crowded that day. Pow checks out fast, and the sooner you get to it, the better chance you get the goods instead of someone else's leftovers. Don't be afraid to arrive well before the lifts open. Sometimes I take one run on a pow day and I say to myself, if I don't get to snowboard another run today, that one run was worth all the effort and I can die a happy man. That's how good it was when it was untouched on that first run of the day. All right, so you've got a pow board, your stance is set back, you have bib snow pants, waterproof jacket zipped up. You roll off the lift and you get stuck. Just kidding, you wouldn't make that mistake because you know that in pow, you need to ride steeper terrain than you're used to, and you need to go faster than how fast you normally ride. Pow is slow, and you need steep to keep momentum. If you normally ride blue squares, try stepping it up to a black diamond. The thing is, pow is soft, and if you fall, you won't get hurt as easily, and it's easier to get back up from a fall on a steeper slope, so you're not gonna get stuck as often if you ride steeper stuff. If it's your first time riding pow, try to pick a groomed run, and then you can dip in and out of the pow along the sides of the run. That way you can try it without getting stuck, and you can use that groomer to get your speed back if needed. But let me be clear, riding pow is not like riding a groomer, for a number of reasons. Number one, you have to lean back. Depending on how deep it is, it's almost like you're doing a tail press on the ground. Now, the more your stance is set back, the more your board will do the work for you. You can practice this stance on a groomer by leaning back and making some turns on your back foot. Keep your nose up and your tail down. Now this is gonna burn that back leg. So if you're out of shape, try adding squats to your preseason workout routine so you don't get worn out in just one pow run. Now because you're floating, you don't wanna lean too hard on your edges in pow. The back foot isn't just for keeping your nose out of the snow to avoid ragdolling, it's also for steering. You're gonna turn on the back of your board in powder. Now you can try this out on the groomer, do a little wheelie and turn side to side. Number two, you have to go fast. The number one tip for riding pow is ride with speed. It makes everything easier. It's like a boat in water. The slower you go, the more you'll sink. The faster you go, the more you'll float on top. As I've said before, pow slows you down a lot, which means not only can you ride steeper stuff, but you can stop faster. This means you can hit a line with a very short run out that you could never hit without the pow. You can charge down mogul fields full speed. You can hit a kicker into the trees because with pow, you can stop on a dime, which also means if there is a flat area ahead, then point it. When you come to a flat area, get out of the powder and get into someone else's track so you don't lose all of your speed and get stuck. Now, if you're the very first person on the mountain, like I suggested, try to avoid flat areas altogether until they have some tracks in them. Tip number three, move like water. You never know what's underneath the pow. So first of all, avoid areas of low coverage and watch out for tree stumps, rocks, and other things that are hiding under that snow. Don't be tempted in the early season to launch into what looks like a perfect pow field because it could be full of rocks, and I know that from experience. Second, even when there's snow underneath, it can be crunchy, it can be ice, it can be mowgli, or any other conditions. Like here when I thought I would sink in on the landing, and instead I bounce right off. So you can see how different this snowpack is even from turn to turn. So to deal with the variable conditions, use loose hips, loose knees, and a strong core. Let that board find its way like water searching out a path down a stream. This way you can quickly adapt to whatever is underneath. And if you're leaning back and riding loose, you can ride over almost anything in the pow. Tip number four, be careful. There are tree wells, avalanches, concealed rocks, and getting stuck in places that you don't want to be stuck that will take you 2 hours to hike out of. These are just some of the many dangers of riding pow. While it is soft, you have to watch out for these things. Always ride with the accountability system on a pow day. Have a partner and keep track of each other. Stay in bounds, don't duck ropes, and don't ride outside the resort unless you have trainings and the avalanche danger is low enough. Don't be tempted by one good pow line. It's not worth losing your life over. All right, some common things that go wrong riding powder on a snowboard. Number one, by far and away, is you catch your nose. This is usually called a ragdoll, where you tumble head over feet because you look like a limp ragdoll with how fast you'll tumble. Now you want to beware of the scorpion when you catch your nose, which is where instead of rolling over your front shoulder, you just plant on your chest. This can really mess up your back, so always tuck your lead shoulder when you catch your nose so you roll over like a tame dog or a front flip instead of a scorpion. Number two, getting stuck. You will get stuck in powder and it will be frustrating. Try to keep your speed up, bend at the knees, not the waist, and point it out of flat areas. Keep that nose up at all times. When you do get stuck, plant your tail in the snow and swivel around so your nose is pointing straight up out of the snow. Even if you're lying on your back, the tail is planted in the snow and the nose is pointing straight up. Use your tail as a pivot point and push yourself up and down the hill while leaning back. Now, if you do have to dig yourself out of powder, it will get hot very quickly. You'll be tempted to take off your outerwear. Don't take your gloves off. Don't unzip your jacket. This will only fill your outerwear with snow, and when your sweat freezes, it can get very dangerous very quickly, especially if you're hiking out of a remote area. So stay dry out there. Now, my biggest tip to avoid getting stuck would be don't stop. Just point it in the pow. Beyond that, if you have to stop, then try not to sit down and get yourself stuck. Mistake number four is your goggles fog up on a pow day. The best way to deal with this is you can take off your goggles or just your lenses in the lift line, put them in your goggle bag, and you can even tuck them up into your armpits in the lift line so they thaw out. Now, beware of wiping snow off the inside of your lenses as that can damage the lens. So just try to shake that snow out and then let it thaw out inside your jacket. Number four thing that goes wrong is PAL will ruin snowboarding for you, and you'll never be able to go back to riding ice on the East Coast. You'll quit your job, leave your family, and chase storms all over the world. How do you think I know this? So that's it, riding PAL. Set your stance back, lean back, upright posture, steer with your back foot like a rudder on a boat. Avoid flat areas, beware of what's underneath the snow, and send it full speed. Go out there, give it a shot. That's all for today. Peace out, Shredder.